This is a practice exercise from page 122 in the textbook, using our solubility guidelines to determine which products are going to be precipitates, and then writing out complete reactions. So anytime I do one of these problems, I have my two reactants given to me, and I'm going to need to write out the products. In order to write the products, it helps me to see what the ions are in my reactants. So we're going to take our two reactants, the iron sulfate and the lithium hydroxide, and figure out what ions are present. If I look at the iron sulfate, I should recognize that iron is a transition metal, meaning it can have multiple charges. So in order to figure out what the charge is on that iron cation, I can work backwards from the charge of the sulfate anion. And you should recognize sulfate as a polyatomic ion, that's SO4 with a 2 negative charge. Since there are 3 sulfate anions, the total negative charge in that compound is negative 6, which means the total positive charge must be positive 6, and I get that plus 6 charge from 2 iron cations, meaning each iron cation must have a 3 positive charge. Do the same thing for the lithium hydroxide. Lithium always has a charge of plus 1, and hydroxide is a polyatomic ion, always has a charge of negative 1. So, when these two solutions react, they form new products. Products always pair a cation with an anion. Since the iron cation has already been with sulfate, in the products, it's going to be with the hydroxide. And then the only other cation and anion pair I have is the lithium sulfate. So I want to write out formulas for these, taking into account the charges. So my iron hydroxide compound is going to look like FeOH3, because I need 3 hydroxide anions to balance the charge on the iron cation. Do the same thing for the lithium sulfate. I'm going to need 2 lithium cations to balance the charge on the sulfate anion. Now the question actually asks me what compound precipitates. So I need to use my solubility guidelines in order to figure out what's going to precipitate. So I've got a hydroxide anion and I've got a sulfate anion. First thing we come to in the chart is the sulfate ion. If you look at sulfate, it's got exceptions for strontium, barium, mercury, and lead, none of which I have. So my sulfate was paired with lithium. That is not an exception, so this will be a soluble compound. So let's look at the next one, the iron hydroxide. Again, using my solubility guidelines, I can find hydroxide. I can see that hydroxide is listed in the insoluble compounds, and that iron is not there as an exception. That means that my iron hydroxide must be insoluble. Since it's insoluble, that is what precipitates. The next thing they want me to do is to write a balanced equation for this reaction. We already know what the reactants are, so we just need to write those in. We started with the iron sulfate . We know that's an aqueous solution that reacted with the lithium hydroxide, which we also know is an aqueous solution. We know that one of our products was iron hydroxide, and since that was insoluble, that means it's a solid. And our other product was lithium sulfate, and since that's soluble, we know it's aqueous. The next thing we want to do is balance. So taking a look at both sides of this equation, we should see that there are 2 iron atoms here, but only 1 here. So I'm going to put a coefficient of 2 in front of that compound. Taking a look at the sulfate, I can see that there are 3 sulfate groups here, but only 1 sulfate group here. So I want to put a coefficient of 3 on that compound. And now that shows me that I've got 6 hydroxides and 6 lithiums, which means I'm going to need a coefficient of 6 on the lithium hydroxide. So now I've written a complete balanced reaction, including my states. Make sure you include your states when you write out your reactions. Okay, the last problem here asks, will a precipitate form when solutions of barium nitrate and potassium hydroxide are mixed? Again, I want to figure out which ions are present. Should know based on its location in the periodic table that barium has a charge of 2 positive. You should recognize the nitrate polyatomic ion as NO3 with a negative charge. Potassium has a positive charge, and the hydroxide ion has a negative charge. I am going to make my new pairs, cation with anion, cation with anion, and write out my new products. Barium hydroxide, I need two hydroxide ions to balance the charge on the barium. And my potassium nitrate, I just need one of each. Now I can use my solubility rules to figure out if I have any soluble or insoluble compounds. So for the barium hydroxide, again, I'm going to look down here at hydroxide. So hydroxide compounds are typically insoluble, but if I look at my exceptions, there is an exception for barium, which means that this compound is actually soluble. So again, normally with hydroxide, we'd be insoluble, but this time we have an exception, so this is a soluble compound. For the next one, the potassium nitrate, we should recognize that all nitrates are soluble, no exceptions there. So since I have two soluble compounds, that means that no precipitate will form, and PPT is just an abbreviation for precipitate.